But first, the coaching defection that's left the football world gobsmacked. Ross Lyon has been paraded in Fremantle colours just 24 hours after walking out on the Saints. To help join the dots, we're joined now by 10 senior football reporter Rob Waters. And Rob, where do we begin?
Well, Helen, it's been a stunning series of developments. Lyon had told his management to get a deal done at St Kilda, then, without their knowledge, struck his own at Fremantle. A deeply wounded Mark Harvey has been knifed in the back, and the reeling Saints have to pick up the pieces. Our coverage begins in Perth, where Fremantle unveiled its new coach. Tim Gossage was there. And Tim, Lyon walked into an angry reception, but he remained defiant and gave the Saints a whack on the way through.
Certainly did, Rob. It was cool, it was calculated, and it was a clinical performance by Ross Lyon today at his first press conference as a Fremantle Dockers coach. He basically said it happened very quickly, the last 3 days. He was first notified 12 days ago from Fremantle that he was keen, but he wanted to continue as coach of St Kilda. But in the last 3 days, things have picked up. And he said the Saints had basically 6 months to do a deal for him, but that wasn't done. And he was very happy with the opportunity given to him at Fremantle. The fans are unhappy. The players, mixed reaction from the Dockers players. The basic thing is that Mark Harvey was a very popular coach and a very popular person in the Perth sporting community. One thing's for sure, it's been a volatile 24 hours.
Proudly parading in purple, Ross Lyon is unapologetic about his messy move to Fremantle and fired a pointed parting shot at St Kilda.
I sit here very comfortable with my integrity and my honour. I've exercised a clause in my contract. My negotiations were started in April. I asked for a 4-year unconditional deal. That wasn't forthcoming until Wednesday afternoon. Fremantle professionally were able to lock and load a 4-year term that had satisfied me within 72 hours in comparison to 6 months. So in the end, it was a relatively easy decision.
Facing an intense interrogation, Lyon stood firm when asked if he'd stabbed former Dockers coach Mark Harvey in the back.
Not particularly, no. I've been headhunted by the Fremantle Football Club and an attractive offer was put in front of me. I'm an AFL career coach. I have a young family, 3 children and a wife. They are my purpose. And at the other end, I had no involvement or no understanding of the relationship between Fremantle Football Club and Mark Harvey. So as I sit here today, I hold my head high.
A shattered Harvey flew out of Perth this morning and will take a holiday before assessing his options.
How's that? How you feeling, mate?
Will you speak?
How are you coping, mate? You okay?
Morning, mate.
And he wants it very clear that he's extremely disappointed with the senior executive of the Fremantle Footy Club, and as he should be.
In a further twist, Elite Sports Properties was also managing Lyon, but they've since parted ways.
When we're not aware of what's going on and we're not actually in the process of negotiating any arrangement, it's hard then to represent someone and say you represent someone.
It's a fairly unsavoury thing for football, to be brutally honest. The words integrity and loyalty is something I think we built our game on, and the last thing we want to see is those words watered down.
Nathan Templeton, 10 News.
So as Fremantle trumpeted one of the great sporting coups, the Saints are still coming to terms with the coach who marched out of St Kilda. Ian Cohen is at Saints headquarters. And Ian, will St Kilda ever forgive Ross Lyon?
Well, Rob, that's the big question here, because St Kilda at the moment are a bit like a prize fighter, just having to drag themselves back up off the canvas after only 24 hours' notice to be able to digest and react to this situation. Forgiveness seems to be in their repertoire at the moment, because despite the fact that their coach has flown west to join Fremantle, they seem to be offering no anger. There is a mix of disbelief, maybe shock, but really no anger here, and maybe there is forgiveness. This is how today unfolded. It's one of the biggest off-field blindsides the competition has ever seen.
Been in footy that long, nothing really amazes you, but a bit of a surprise. I thought, as the rest of the club did, that sort of Ross was under control, but obviously he wasn't.
Players and staff stunned.
A bit weird, isn't it? Yeah, a bit of a shock.
What are you expecting today?
Don't know, I've got to go in and find out.
Just shocked, mate, trying to work out what's going on, so we'll hopefully know some more soon.
Yeah, well, it was certainly well done, wasn't it?
Once there, the players milled, awaiting direction. Lenny Hayes was working on his rebuilt knee, while the skipper, fresh from hospital, was clearly pained by his.
Open that door for me, mate. Be a human being and open the door for me.
That's right.
Good on you, mate.
That's the next one, I think. I'm sorry, mate.
After meeting with the players, the power brokers emerged with measured determination.
Ross was, we are,
and we are going ahead with our business, right? So all due respect to Ross, right, he did a great job, but we've now got a future to look forward to.
But that was as tough as the talking got.
There's great respect in this club for Ross Lyon. He's done a wonderful job at this club. He's got a great relationship, working relationship with the players. He's got a great working relationship with the executive. So clearly we were disappointed.
I wouldn't say betrayed because, football's that sort of business.
Oh, look, I don't think we feel deceived. I said, as I've stated previously, there's a high level of respect for Ross.
Head office not prepared to tip the bucket, while the on-field leaders offered little on the defection of their former coach.
As skipper, Nick, you not wanting to speak to the fans?
Good one.
And as if the Saints saga couldn't get worse, an opportunistic union protest against one of the club's sponsors topped off a horror 24 hours.
So wasn't that just the icing on the cake, the union display here? Now, this is the way it's going to work. They're putting together a panel to select the new coach. It includes Michael Nettlefold and Chris Pelkin from the administration side, and also past champions Andrew Thompson and also Nathan Burke. But they are four deep at the moment because the D's, the Dogs and the Crows are already a long way down their path of trying to find a new coach. The jungle drums are beating this afternoon as well regarding the Demons. There is speculation that Mark Neill could be very close to signing up there at Melbourne. Well, wait and watch this space as far as that's concerned. Of course, in the middle of all of this, there's some semi-final football to be played as well. You can't forget that. And at the MCG tonight, it's all about Hawthorn and the Sydney Swans. There is some footy in action. Kelly Underwood's there, and Kel, a big one tonight.
Ian, it certainly is. You wouldn't believe it, but there is a game of football happening here tonight. The semi-final showdown well and truly overshadowed by the drama of today. Of course, there's still a bit of drama surrounding this match as well, and that's Buddy Franklin. Will he or won't he? I can tell you, I just got off the phone to an official from the Hawthorn Football Club, and I quote, he pulled up beautifully after his light run at the MCG yesterday, and he is a certain starter tonight. Also spoke to the Swans camp. They are very confident that he will play as well, so it'll be a bit of a surprise if Buddy Franklin's name isn't on the team sheet when it's released in just over an hour. They're expecting up to 50,000 at the MCG here tonight. And of course, the winner will play Collingwood in a preliminary final back here at the MCG next Friday night, and the chance to move through to a grand final. Helen.
Thanks to Kelly at the G, Ian Cohen at Saints headquarters, and of course, Tim Gossage in Perth.